Nevada Wolfpack will take on the South Florida Bulls tomorrow in Nevada. Should be a great game, especially Nevada coming off a 31-24 victory over the Cal Bears. I'm Dan Harrelson alongside Nick Taylor. And let's talk about tomorrow's big game with the voice of the Wolfpack, Ryan Radke. Ryan, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great, fellas. How are you?
Pretty well.
Come on. Doing great.
Well, big win last week, like I just stated, 31-24 victory over the Cal Bears. Talk about that win last week and going into this week, another big game.
Yeah, it certainly was a big win last week, fellas. We obviously, in this part of the country, and being a Mountain West team, you get a chance to go take on a Pac-12 club and do it not just in their house, but the season opener. That was a big game for Cal, the first game in their newly renovated stadium. And they were excited. It was sold out. It was a great atmosphere. The Wolfpack really went into that game with a lot of question marks. It's a very young, very inexperienced team. And one of the big questions was just how they would respond to going into a hostile environment for the first time. And they really handled themselves well. Not that they played a perfect game. They didn't. But they were able to overcome some adversity, overcome some mistakes, and it's a good win over Cal. It was a great way to start the season. I think a lot of people, when they looked into that schedule, said, well, they're going to be 0-1 going into the South Florida game. But to get that victory under their belt is big. I can tell you this, that going into the game tomorrow, there's a lot of folks, including the Nevada coaches, who feel like South Florida is a better team than Cal. And so even though the game is going to be at home as opposed to being on the road, they feel like this will be just as big, if not a bigger challenge. They'll give them a bowl, but what they saw for the Golden Bears last week.
I would agree, Ryan, and that kind of leads into my next question. South Florida obviously is a contender to win the Big East Conference, and of course, you guys defeated Cal and Pac-12 school last week, as you mentioned. I know it's early and it's only week two, but is there any kind of stir in the fan base of possibly making a magical run and playing in a BCS game? I mean, the bare fact of the matter is you guys beat a formidable Cal team, and now if you beat South Florida, I think he's contender, and all of a sudden there's a topic of conversation about that.
Yeah, I don't think anybody is talking BCS at this point. That probably goes back to a couple of years ago. You know, Nevada had a great 2010 season. They knocked off Boise State to end that year. They finished 13-1. It was the best season in school history. And despite the fact they beat a Boise team, and a lot of people were talking about the BCS club, the Wolfpack was never really under consideration for that type of thing. So I don't think anybody's getting caught up in BCS or anything right now, but I think they recognize that if Nevada is able to win a ball game tomorrow against South Florida, you know, then you're really in a good spot if you put yourself ahead of the curve, so to speak. But again, when with such a young and inexperienced team, you wonder how they're going to respond to things week by week. If they can build on what they did a week ago and beat a good South Florida club, then you really get some momentum, you really get some confidence rolling for this ball club, which, you know, could be really big for them as the season goes along, especially as they start to get into conference play. You know, the first year play of the Mountain West Conference, that's a big deal for a lot of folks around here. So they'd love to have a good showing in that first season in the new league.
Well, Ryan, last week against Cal, it looked like a very balanced offensive attack for the Wolfpack. 230 yards through the air, 145 on the ground by Jefferson. Brandon Wimberly brought in 83 yards receiving-wise. No passing touchdowns, but it looks like three rushing touchdowns by Jefferson last week. Is Chris all? What did he have to say this week after the Cal game with the offense? Is he happy? Does he think it's balanced enough? What were his thoughts this week?
Yeah, he was real happy with the offensive execution against Cal. You know, guys, the pistol offense is really based around being a power running game. And so he's excited any time that his team can rack up yards on the ground. Chris Nevada did. Stephon Jefferson now is kind of a guy at running back after being a backup the last couple of years. And he really played well. Wolfpack was able to push the ball in the end zone down inside the 20. That was big for them. And you mentioned the passing game. You know, Nick Romo has just come in this year as the offensive coordinator. Chris Dahl really has not had an offensive coordinator over his time in Nevada. But he brought in Nick Romo to a Dallas staff in Hawaii. And, of course, you know, nobody puts the ball in the air as much as Hawaii has the last couple of years. And he did that because he felt like Rolovich, with his view on the passing game, could probably add to the pistol offense and make it even more formidable. I think coming out of the first week, they were really happy with what they got there. Cody Fajardo, the quarterback, threw the ball extremely well. result last season because of injury, came back and some big third down catches. He was real happy with the way that the offense played. He said to me yesterday on his coach's show, it was far from perfect, but it was a great start, and he really feels what he can make it. Continue to move on those things and go forward. They're going to be in good shape offensively if the season goes along.
Well, Ryan, obviously, to build off the previous question, the Pistol offense, Chris Ault is the father of the modern Pistol offense, and with that being said, just as someone who has covered Nevada as a play-by-play announcer, if you will, is Nevada's success largely attributed to the Pistol system or the Pistol offense, or is it more about the players than people might think? Because when I watch Nevada, I'm from the southeast part of the country, and I'm impressed with Nevada, but when I watch them, I often think that it's their coaching and their scheme that wins games for them more than anything, because I can remember back, years ago when they weren't getting the recruits that they're getting now, they were still winning games. So what's your take on that?
I certainly don't want to take any credit away from the players, guys, because they go out there and do it on Saturday afternoon, but I don't think there's any doubt that much of Nevada's success is attributed to the scheme, Pistol, the way they execute. It's difficult to prepare for, especially when you have a short time to prepare for it and you don't see a lot of what Nevada does. You know, a lot of teams around the country will use the Pistol formation. Well, we see that all over the place now, and it's become kind of a rage in college football. But nobody outside of Nevada runs a full-fledged Pistol offense. UCLA tried to do it last year, and it just didn't work out for them. You really have to commit to run this offense. And I think what Chris Ault has done in designing it and really tweaking it every year, adding to it, it's been a lot of fun to watch. Now, certainly they've had some really good players. You know, Colin Kaepernick, who's now a backup quarterback for the 49ers, he had a record-breaking career at Nevada, not just Nevada records, but national records. He did a tremendous job running this offense. Cody Fajardo, the guy who's a quarterback now, they really like his future. They think that he could be a Kaepernick-type guy. They're almost out looking for those type of dual-threat quarterbacks that can run and pass. And they like the talent they're getting, but Nevada is never going to be a place that goes out and